everyone. I'm Matt Longino.
And I'm Nicolette Navarro, and we are the directors of Lily Bonnaby as well.
We want to thank you all for coming out tonight and supporting Little Theater, and we're really excited that we have a full house tonight.
You may have noticed that your ticket was free, and we rely on donations to keep the club going. So,
During intermission and after the show, we will have free will offerings available.
And please join the cast after for our meet and greet and light refreshments.
So, without further ado, thank you again for your support, and we present to you
Legally Blonde the Musical.
Hello, and welcome to Marie Madej Theater. Please take this time to silence your cell phones and any other electronics. In case of an emergency, exits are located to the right and the rear of the theater. Now please, sit back and enjoy the Canisius College Little Theater production of Heather Hack's Legally Blonde the Musical. Thank you.
kind of silk. It'll pucker. And you didn't just get this in because I saw it in last May's Vogue.
Oh my God, you guys.
I'm not about to buy last year's dress at this year's price.
Bounce all right through the sales girl's lies.
It may be perfect for a blonde, but I'm not that blonde. I may be in love, but I'm a stupid lady.
I'm gonna be a senator when I'm 30. I'm gonna need somebody. See you. got some dreams to make true. I thought that you'd understand. It's time to get serious. Time to get serious. Check, please.
Yes, the East Coast is boring. There's no Too.
This is not personal essay.
Yeah, this is so boring. anyone reason to admit you.
How about love? You ever been in love? 'Cause if you have, you'll know that love never accepts a defeat. No challenge it can't meet, no place it cannot go. Don't say no to love and love. Don't laugh when I say love. Don't think they're naive. Because even a person who's smart can listen to their heart. Listen and believe. So believe in what love is.
Perfect.
You need Woods, Kamel. I think this is yours.
Is this my social agenda?
No, it's your academic roster.
Right, there's that. Let's totally catch up after class.
Who is she? My ex-girlfriend.
All that pink you're wearing, is that even legal?
Pink's my signature color.
So I gathered.
All right, everyone take your seats. Callahan should be here any second. 3 years ago today, I was sitting right where you're sitting, and I've heard the same rumors I'm sure you've heard too. Callahan's ruthless. He bathes in the blood of sheep. Only partly true. What you really need to know is...
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say will be used against you. Now, when you choose a law career the moment you embark, there is that joke you're bound to hear. A lawyer is a shark. Ignore that. It's simplistic and it's dumb. Only some of you will turn out sharks. Just some. The rest are chump. Our topic is blood in the water. Kids, it's time you faced. Law school is a waste. Oh yes, unless you acquire a taste for blood in the water. Dark and red and raw, you're nothing until the thrill of a kill becomes your only law. Mr. Schultz, hypothetical question. Would you be willing to defend the following banker accused of fraud? A kind old grandma saved and she sent it. Off to your client, all she saved since she was born. Well, he promised to invest it, but he spent it on prostitutes and heroin. And
no, I would not take that case.
Wrong! This one is a windlass, you lazy! Grandma's throat has happily laid.
We're understanding colorally crazy.
The guy goes free and he can get you high and late.
Look for the blood in the water. Read your comments out. Only spineless snobs will quarrel with the morally dubious job.
Willing to defend the following client. Say they offer you a bundle for defending. A famous hitman, a mafia elite. Seems he missed his chosen prey, killed it up and drove away, running over three cute puppies in the street.
What, you think I wouldn't defend him just because he's like a typical man?
Oh, you lesbians think you're so tough.
Oh dear, I fear my comments have offended you. Hard to argue though when you're too mad to speak. Your employment will be very quickly ended when they see how your emotions make you weak. So what's my point? I run a $1 billion law firm, and I hire 4 new interns every year. From this class, I will select 4 young sharks for my respect, and those 4 will have a guaranteed career.
Do you follow? So I wanna see what?
Blood in the water.
Exactly, let the game begin. 4 of you will win. But just those 4 really your soul crazy, yes. Blood in the water. So white and stripes and floor.
Yes, Ms.
What? And what?
Someone said there's more coffee. Would you please summarize the case of State of Indiana be heard from your reading, please?
Oh, I wanted to answer the puppy question.
But I'm asking you about the assigned reading.
Okay. Who assigns reading for the first day of class?
You have guts, Miss Woods. Ms. Kensington, let us say you teach a class at Harvard Law School. A position that you're just proud about. But a girl on whom you call hasn't read the case at all. Should you let it go, or...
I broke her out.
All right, then. You heard your classmates. You have just met you. She cut your throat, so grab your coat. Yes, you've got guts.
But trust me, your law career is not over.
Law career? So not the problem. Listen, I need to get back into class with Warner. Can you help me?
Yeah, come back tomorrow and make sure you've done your reading.
Right. Excuse me, but why would you do that to another girl?
Do what?
Well, we girls have to stick together. We can't try and look good by making each other look bad.
I didn't make you look bad. You just weren't prepared. Try opening up a law book for once, but I should warn you, they don't come with pictures.
I'll just leave you two alone then.
Aren't there girls going wild somewhere without you?
Hey!
Warner, thank God you're here!
Elle, I'm sorry.
Sorry about what? Warner, is there something you'd like to share with Elle?
Do you know her?
Yeah. Elle, Vivian and I went to boarding school together. And she's my girlfriend now.
I'm sorry, I just hallucinated. What did you just say?
He said I'm his girlfriend.
Girlfriend!
Back guys. Anyway, she's twice my size. She's got a plan B.
He's dating an evil preppy. Ugh.
So what's she got that you don't got? Three tits?
She's serious.
Seriously, she got three tits?
No, she's a constipated polo shirt with a mousy brown bob. But apparently that's what Warner wants, so you have to make me a brunette.
Whoa, whoa, whoa! Do you know the number one reason behind all bad hair decisions? Love. You're lost without your love. Your heart is on the floor. I can help you. I've been there before. When I need to relax, I just put on some tracks from this CD I bought for the store.
Paulette, you have no idea how much I need.
up like it meant to be said.
Thank you.
What's up?
Love.
Excuse me?
I put my faith in love. I followed where it led.
Love led you here.
To my personal circle of hell. It has not worked out well. I wish that I were dead.
You came out here to follow a man. Harvard Law was just part of that plan. Man, what rich, romantic planet are you from?
Malibu.
Instead of lying outside with a pool, you stalked some guy to an Ivy League school. That's the weirdest reason I have. Okay. I grew up in the Roxbury slums with my mom and a series of bums. Guys who showed me all the ways a man can fail. I got through law school by busting my ass. Two jobs in addition to class. So forgive me for that weeping at your tail.
Excuse me, just because you have some kind of chip on your shoulder.
You know what? You're right. There's a chip on my shoulder. As well.
I'm sorry, but that sounds highly negative.
Hey, I'm just being honest. When you weren't born into Brooklyn, you gotta work twice as hard. And I want my sweatshirt.
Wait, two jobs plus law school?
I haven't slept since 1998.
Seriously, how do you do it?
Well, I don't go to parties a lot. Not good use of the time that I've got. Can't spend hours doing my hair.
Malum prohibitum.
act prohibited.
It's an act prohibited by law, like jaywalking or chewing gum in Singapore.
Therefore, malum in se means
an action that is evil in itself. Assault, murder, white shoes after Labor Day.
Good. Where are you going?
Well, home, of course. It's Thanksgiving break, remember?
Interesting.
What?
Well, I predict you will probably pass.
Yes!
In the bottom percent of your class.
What?
If you're going for mediocre, you've done great.
That's not fair.
Look, they laughed at me, like they're laughing at you. We can't win if we don't follow through.
She got a chip on.
strong, independent woman, and you must be reunited with your dog.
Anyone who bakes a cake for their dog on their birthday deserves nothing but the best.
It is shaped like a bone.
That kind of devotion can't be ignored.
It's not easy for any dog-friendly chocolate substitutes.
Crap, not you again! Paula, get your fat ass off my property!
Wanna see my dog, Dewey? I got it right! I bet you didn't even know it was his birthday today.
Aw, it's your birthday? It's your birthday! I can't see it, jelly gut! Best decision I ever made? Throwing you out!
Can you believe I lived with that for 10 years? That cheapskate never even bought me a ring!
Elle, they lived together for 10 years.
Emmett, you're a genius!
Now what?
Mr. Dewey, we are Miss Bonafonte's legal team.
Lawyers?
I don't think you understand that the great Commonwealth of Massachusetts identifies yours and Miss Bonafonte's 10-year relationship as a common law marriage, which entitles her to equitable division of property.
Huh?
Translation? We're taking a dog!
Is that my name? I don't know what that is. What's up with my friend? I'm in this. Is this a mistake in my ear?
is a pound or two. Then you can turn this off right now. My workout's not for you. I'm talking to the woman who wants it all. Gotta pay for what you get. The size too close, don't come too low. Too lazy to sweat. I want you with me to shake. When I say jump, say how high. You know you're doing it right. When you start to cry, if you don't look like you should, you've got to win.
There is a significant amount of evidence against you. To free you, the jury will need to hear an alibi.
even though it can save you.
Nope. Put me on the stand and I'll be forced to lie.
All right, then, Ms. Windham, if we can't hear an alibi, then you should accept a plea bargain.
And admit to something I didn't do?
But with a plea bargain, you get out in a couple of years. That sounds reasonable, right?
Reasonable to do time for my husband's killer? Not really.
Wow, she's tough. Yo, sister.
Yo, not related. I'm the defense team who knows I'm innocent. Get out of here, all of you.
Who is the girl with loyal friends and true? Who has a bond as strong as crazy glue? Who can sail the Collins sisters all come through? Delta Nu, 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 Delta Nu, 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 you are a Delta Nu. Delta Nu, 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 Delta Nu, 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 you are a Delta Nu! Hal was former UCLA president of Delta Nu. I knew I recognized you, my child.
Oh, shut up.
Yeah, your DVDs got me in shape to be June for the girls from UCLA calendar. Sisterhood's forever. I believe you, Brooke, and I will do everything in my power to clear your good name. But that involves an alibi.
I can't tell it.
Everyone has their secrets, Brooke. For years, I denied my highlights.
It's beyond highlights now. My secret is nuclear, and if it gets out, I could lose my entire fitness empire, which means everything to me. If I tell you, will you Delta Nu sisters swear not to tell anyone?
I will double Delta Nu sister swear.
You're hardcore. Okay. On the day my husband was killed, I had...
What?
Wait.
Brooke, you're gonna have to speak up. I can't hear you.
Liposuction! It only means an outpatient lipo.
Oh my
god! I had to do it. Some serious cottage cheese was showing up on my ass.
Your secret's safe with me, Brooke.
You gotta take care of me. All my fans are counting on me. You swore.
Al, there you are.
Where's Brooke?
The guard took her back.
Great.
But I got her alibi.
You're kidding, so what is it?
Well, I'm afraid I can't tell you.
Why not?
Because I double Delta Nu sister swore not to.
Al, this is not some little sorority thing.
Oh, I know. It's a big sorority thing. But don't worry. Brooke really had nothing to do with this. Think about it. Brooke is a fitness queen. Exercise gives you endorphins. Endorphins make you happy. Happy people don't just kill their husbands.
Are you serious? If you give up this alibi, we could all lose the case.
And we're not very good lawyers.
Would you stop being such a Marilyn L? Listen, Poop L. Callahan wants that alibi. Give it to him, and you can sail through law school. Knowing there's a big, fat job offer waiting for you when you get out.
I gave her my word, Warner.
So what? Who cares?
Who cares?
Emmett, let me be very clear. I gave you simple instructions. Lead this legal team and get me an alibi. You're 0 for 2. Everyone, field trip's over. Let's go, back to work. Except you two. I'd rather not see ratty corduroy or legally blonde again today.
Sorry.
I don't need you to be sorry, Elle. I need you to tell me the alibi.
I can't, because I gave Brooke my word. Having an alibi isn't the only way to win this case.
No, but it sure would help.
Work with me. We'll free Brooke the right way, the noble way.
This isn't a Lifetime original movie, Elle. I'm not interested in nobility right now. I'm more interested in saving Brooke's life.
No, you're more interested in impressing Callahan.
Well, he is my boss, and if I impress him, he'll make me associate.
And jeopardize your client's trust and our integrity.
You put it that way.
Exactly, butthead. My word means something, and I know yours does too.
No one's called me a butthead since third grade.
Maybe not to your face. Come on, let's get out of here.
Why do you always have to be right?
I don't have to be. When I'm with you, I just am. Listen, if you want to impress Callahan, I can help.
Okay, hop.
So not in Callahan's vocabulary.
Didn't your mother ever tell you about not judging a book by its cover?
She did, but I also know that books with tattered covers stay on the shelf.
Ah, thanks a lot.
And that this isn't a perfect world that we live in. I think I haven't been judged my whole life. I think it wasn't a good idea for me to make navy my new paint.
No, that was a good idea.
I know.
Where are we going exactly?
Well, you trust me, don't you?
Of course.
Don't
stop now. What is this place?
It's called a department store.
It's
first a deep breath. Take it all in. Feel all those halogens warming your skin. Smell how they pump in pure oxygen. See, they care. Love.
Excuse me?
Love, the new fragrance from Chanel.
No, thank you.
I know you're scared. Nevertheless, think of the people you want to impress. Swallow your pride for me. Just not that.
What's that smell?
Sometimes by Calvin Klein.
That I don't like. That's kind of neat. Guys who wear that get beat up on my street. Still I've come this far, I can't retreat. In my shell, I'm in the hands of hell. What the hell?
think that might be a bit too much.
Classy lawyer pink it is. When the jury people see those nails, they'll know they can trust you.
Which is more than my team is doing. They're all over me to give up Brooke's alibi.
Including your friend, Emmett?
Well, he is on the team too.
Yeah, in more ways than one. I see the way he looks at you.
Paulette, he's just my friend.
Right! And I could use a friend like that.
I've got a package for Miss Paulette Buonaparte. Name's Kyle. This is my new route and my first stop of the day. Kind of cool karma, huh?
Come and play. My God, Emmett! Is that you?
Hell took me shopping.
You look sharp.
Chop one up or out.
Day 3 of Brooklyn Number Trial. D.A. Joyce Riley has been grilling Nico's Arch Tacos. He's been a schoolboy all morning. The water is still good, guys. Let's hope the defense bank is loaded. Katie?
Which is why you should clarify for the court exactly what your duties were as schoolboy.
Cleaning the pool. That was my uniform.
And was it Brooks' idea to have you wear this uniform?
Yes.
And could you please explain exactly where your relationship was to the defendant?
Brooke and I were loving.
No further questions.
He was your lover?
No! I thought you would never sleep with a man in a thong.
Unbelievable.
Your Honor, I request a 10-minute recess.
Why was I not alerted to the setback?
I mean, it is a setback.
It's moaning.
Paulette, what's up?
Hey, now. I just wanted to call and thank you. The bandit snap worked. I may have broken Kyle's nose, but I got to spend 4.5 hours with him in the ambulance and at the ER.
Paulette, that's so great. I told you, the bandit snap is infallible unless the guy is gay or some... Oh my God, I gotta go by.
Bye.
Go either way.
Look at that cow.
For decisively turning the case.
And for nailing the pool boy.
And for nailing the pool boy!
Well, I had to share this victory with them.
Damn it, and I can't believe I'm saying it to Ev.
To Ev!
To Ev.
Yeah. Since when did a finely tuned gaydar become qualified as a legal victory?
But without that gaydar, we wouldn't be celebrating with champagne. We'd be dead in the water. Elle Woods has shown more legal smarts than most on my staff. And she won this round, making her a good lawyer. And I'm sure we'd all love to hear that alibi she got, but by keeping it, she never compromised the client's trust, making her a great one.
And that's more than I can say for you, Warner. Why don't you go be useful and get me a coffee?
But we're drinking champagne.
Splendid escape. And as for the rest of you, go home and get a good night's rest. I need you sharp for tomorrow morning. Miss Woods, Warren.
Oh, of course. I'll catch up with you in a second. And thanks, Professor Callahan, for what you said in there. It really meant a lot.
Well, you deserved it. Don't let the other law students know I said so. I've got to scare your reputation.
Don't worry, your secret's safe with me. But I really appreciate this opportunity to work with you. I've learned so much.
What you've learned isn't the point. You have instincts. And instincts, legal or otherwise, can't be taught. Trust your instincts. I thought you were smarter than that.
Is this the only reason you gave me an internship?
Miss Woods, it's been a pleasure working with you. You can show your...
Well, hello, Marilyn. Looks like you'll be making partner now. You've really earned it.
Warner, shut up! Take back the books and pack up the clothes. Clear out the room and jump off the key. Leave with what's left of my dignity. Get in the car and just go. Chalk it all up to experience. They said I failed, but I disagree. Who could say then where my path will be?
Some pieces.
Thank you.
10, Your Honor.
Rule 303 of the Supreme Judicial Court states that a law student, Miss Al Woods, can represent a defendant in criminal proceedings.
Yes, but only if she has a licensed attorney to supervise her, and without me, she does not.
Well, I'm licensed, Your Honor, and I'm gladly supervised.
Like hell you will. You work for me, remember?
No, I work for myself. And I don't have to hit that insurance, Professor.
Enjoy prison, Miss Wyndham.
Okay, bye!
Thank you, Abbott.
You shouldn't actually think I was just gonna let you get away.
Miss Woods, any day now. You may proceed. Call your first witness.
We call Chapman Wyndham to the stand. What was your relationship to the deceased?
He was my father.
And did you actually see the murder take place?
No, I was in the shower. But when I got out, I saw Brooke standing over my dad's body, drenched in his blood.
Oh boy, we're screwed.
Don't listen to him, Al. You're fine. Go ahead.
Miss Wyndham. On the day of the murder, did you see anyone suspicious hanging around?
Suspiciously hanging around in my shower?
No, before that.
No, I was getting hurt.
And then you took a shower?
Yeah, I was in the shower.
Your Honor, I would like to go to the bathroom.
Shouldn't you have gone before the murder trial?
No, I mean I would like us all to go to the bathroom together.
Why do girls always do that?
No, I mean I would like us all to return to the bathroom where this alleged shower took place.
I'll allow it, Miss Woods.
Ah!
seriously. Al, I was wrong.
Thank you, Warner.
We do belong together. You show me what we can be together again.
Oh, Warner. Vivian dumped you, didn't she? Though I dreamed of this day long ago, now my answer is thank you, but no. Look, I've barely begun, I'm hardly through. I was living in ignorant bliss, till I learned I could be more than this. And you know, in a way, I owe it all to you. I thought losing your love was a blow I could ever accept.
Who helped me to prevail?